Hello and welcome to Argument a Podcast. This is after a long time, we're back. We're joined with a special guest today on our podcast program. We have with us Professor Subhrajit Chandra. Sir has done his LLM in sports law from Nottingham Trent University of UK, with especially an international scholarship, and also completed another LLM in energy law from the University of Petroleum and Energy Studies, India. He's also done his BBA LLB from on international trade law and is currently pursuing a PhD in sports law. And sir is also the assistant lecturer at Jindal Law School and is also the founder of GSPR, which mainly focuses on sports related content. So do check it out as well. So sir, welcome to Argument a Podcast. Hope you're doing well, sir.
Thank you, Joel. Thank you for the invitation. So how is everyone with your group and how is you especially?
Yes, sir, I'm doing good. It's especially in this time, it's pretty challenging, but it's pretty good also. Considering. How about you, sir?
Hello. I am also good. Yeah, same thing, challenging. Things are getting a little bit bloated nowadays. But yeah, but we have sports, same which is going on with Thursday Olympic, the India Test Series and all. And somewhere we can manage on that side, right?
Yes, sir.
So thank you. Once again, I'm really grateful to you guys that you both be here. It's super to know about sports law, the fact which India is doing that. So I'm really grateful to you guys also.
Yes, sir. So I think I know you're gonna curse me for saying this, but it's a very generic question. So like for the benefit of the audience as well. What exactly is sports law? And also, I know you have told me earlier as well, it's very wrong to say it, but then is sports law actually very underrated or very new in India, considering the other career options what someone might choose? They might go towards corporate or towards litigation. So something with regard to sports law, how is that particular endeavor successful in India, and what's the current status as such?
See, if you say the current status in India, so once, hopefully you remember, once you have a long chat on this fact, right, for India, I will say that it was there in India, right? It was there in India, because why I'm saying that it was there in India, see, sports law itself, when you go for the definition, they say lex sportiva, and this come from the word deporte, which means to carry on and all. So these are the Latin terms, which you see, Latin terms, and English term, Latin terms and all. So see, we can give different terms to different things, right? In Hindi, we say gari, the same thing in English, we say car, right? The same thing in English, we say sports, in Latin, we say sportiva, or the sporte, and in Hindi, we say kira, right? Now, so if the word is there, it means the law is also there. And the sports law itself is a mixture of many laws. You're getting my point. It has many things from IP, it has IP, it has like it has certain element of contract law, not Indian contract IP. People get confused. Mostly when I go to some places, they say to me like, hey, you are doing sports law. So what's the difference in sports law, Indian contract act? We can do Indian contract act. It's the same thing as sports law. Then I have to define, they know that is different. This is something, that is something. So yeah. So now coming to the another thing, which you just asked, like whether it is something new or not. See, in sports law also, we have a certain part, which is known as, which we will say, or you can say a betting and gambling, which is nowadays going in vast, right?
People are pardon, sir? What did you say?
The part of betting and gambling. Now people are asking question on that fact also, right? What is betting? What is gambling? Then what is fantasy league? Everything. Recently, Supreme Court also came out of Dream 11. That's a game of skill. That is game of chance. So now this all are coming under sports, right? But now if I say this is the rule of sports law, which I want, like we have discussed a long time before. Like we have seen gambling, the story of gambling in Mahabharata also.
Yeah.
Right. Remember in Mahabharata, this team was doing gambling and all.
Yeah.
Right. Shatranj, which you used to say that is a gambling. So if that means then the rules are there itself, right? Maybe it's in the natural law form or it's in a normative law form, but that is there, right? Why I'm saying natural law? Because the God created law, and we say Krishna is a God. He is the character of Mahabharata. And whereas Yudhishthira is a demigod. He's the son of a God, right? Immortal and mortal. So he's a demigod. Now come back. Now we're coming to this something around 1500 BC. Right, I mean 1500 BC means I'm taking about the part where Rig Veda and Athar Veda was there, right? And if I say in this Veda, there is certain like which we say phase or verbs, like there is certain verse I still 10.34.4. certain verse is there. In that verse, it's saying like there is saying like if a gambler wife left alone, and which the mother means the gambler will can make his family like in problem, right? It means to say something like that. I'm not going to do deep on this session. It will take long time, right? Then in Atharva Veda, you fought 38. Same thing. Right, so it means you can getting the point, right? The betting laws, I mean, not with that time betting is not that type of thing, the gambling was, so gambling law was there, you're getting my point.
Yes.
So in seeing this part, I will take you to think what is it, the Manusmriti and Katanya Smriti, these are the two oldest smriti. So I'm not saying about the Indian Gambling Act, the modern generation of the gambling of 2000, I'm taking you to back in that king's time, right? Now if I say there was a rule, so it was a huge problem that time of gambling, right? So in that Katanya Smriti and Manusmriti, it has been mentioned to the king through this verses only, and it was in 9.221 and in 9.222. I still remember this. So what is mentioned? It mentioned this mentioning to king that if you can stop gambling, impose tax on that.
Oh, okay.
Right. I'm not taking you the Sanskrit slow. I'm just telling you what is the English slow. So, if these things are there, so now tell me, it means that sports law was there from the beginning of the society. Just we not.
It wasn't formalized as such. It wasn't formalized as what you see today as such.
Right.
Formally.
So, formulated. In India, I'm taking the example of India itself.
Yeah.
Right from the beginning. So you can understand like it is something like it's not new. Yeah, we can say yes, we can say new in the field like formal, which you just now speak. Like the way they act and all that was the most oldest way, which are lacking behind. Right. So what happening to us? I will say us is something like the knowledge of our is on the dust. It was there. Now if you went to this, I think you guys have went through this internship and all in the district court and high court, and you have seen there's pile of files which are there in this courtrooms and all, right? And the dust is there and all, someone need to remove the dust. This something same thing with us in sports law. It's there, but it's in the pile of dust. We just take that out from the dust and just move it. Then you can find all the script features there. See, which I have told you, again, which I told you, this is all have written, not in the modern sports law I'm telling you about. So you can understand how old is our sports law culture. But now that comes the whole thing, like there is a thing in a case, like if you ask the proper definition of sports, see, this forte or next sportiva, see, people say next sportiva is a jurisdiction of sports, right? But if you think it differently, lex sportiva, lex means law, sportiva means sports, and it's a, you know, it's a Latin term, right? And what is disporte? Just a mentioning, disporte means the carry forward. It's something like English, French, English mixed word. Because in middle term, like middle era, in mid era, I'm talking about that time. You know, in UK also, English was not their official language. It was once upon a time before like this civil war start and all.
Roman.
Before that, it was ruled by, once upon a time, it was also ruled by the French, and the high class used to talk in French in United Kingdom. At that time, it was not known as England that way. So, and English was a lower class word. So they mix these two forms of word, and they make this thing useful. But recently there was a case, R versus Oxfordshire, and this case make improvement of this another part of the story, which say like, what is the legal definition?
Okay.
So, still now we are searching for the legal definition of sports. Were we saying like sports law, we are in sports law, we need to develop sports law. But in the some part of the world, they are still now thinking of that fact. Like, okay, what is the legal definition of sports? And why this came? Because this R versus Oxford case, it happened like there was a green space like in between the village. And it happened like there was, what is the green space is for? So they mentioned this green space is something like a, you know, something which is for the people of the, like for the use of recreation activity and sporting activity. And from this sporting activity, it's been to say like, then the question is, if you are saying sporting activity, what is the definition of sports? So it started from somewhere, from that, like people thinking of initially and all, but still now people are in another part of the world, people are still now searching of that fact. Like, what is the legal definition of sports?
This current episode, the full length, will be available on YouTube, and also you'll be able to find the latest updates about the session as well on Instagram and other platforms as well. So do like, share and subscribe to our channel on YouTube, and also follow our Instagram page with regard to regular updates as well.